some more special integrals. If I make clear, Shweta, what happened, Rishabh? Hope I have written all the steps. Okay, so next is, we are going to talk about some more special integrals. Some more. We already did six of them.
Yeah.
1 by under root x square minus a square, under root x square plus a square, a square minus x square. Some more special integrals. So what is special about them is that they will be using integration by parts. Okay, and their results have to be frequently used at so many places. So we are not only expected to derive them, but also to remember them. So there are three of them. Have you started with integration in school yet?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, sir. Yes. Well, left out for integration.
So, why did it
take? Did you have any what? X by 2 x by 2 under root of x square plus a square plus a square by 2 ln of, can I do a similar activity here also? Can I write it as this? Correct? Now we already know from our prior experience that ln of this with an a down, you can write it as minus ln a, which will get observed in C. So you can just stop here. This result has to be memorized. How to memorize it, I will tell you later on. See, ln of something by something is ln by something minus ln a. Ln a at the end of the day is a constant. Constant plus arbitrary constant will make another arbitrary constant. In indefinite integrals, mostly the constants which are getting corrected in the entire process will ultimately go and be a part of the arbitrary constant. So your final result is x by 2 times under root x square plus a square by 2 ln of x plus under root x square plus a square. If let's say you don't want to use substitution, okay, there's another method to do it. Another way to do the same problem is, let me call this as I first. Okay. Put a 1. Call this as U. Call this as apply integration by parts. So u times integration of 1 is x minus derivative of under root x square plus a square is 1 by 2 under root x square plus a square into 2x, and there is another x because of integration of 1. So this 2 and this 2 will get Vishal. I am making changes. See what I am doing? I am cancelling this 2 and this 2. So it becomes x square by. Correct? Now see what I do. I will be manipulative here, like always. I add an a square and subtract a square. Okay. And let me write another step. Can I write it like this? This 2 I separated, this I separated, and separately divided by the denominator.
So that become 1.
Yes, when I open the bracket, can I write it like this? Yes. And x plus a square by under root x plus a square will become under root of x square plus a square. Can I say this is I once again? Okay. I think I. So let the two I's meet. Then all you can see properly. Correct? Now dx by under root x plus x square plus a square. Is it a special integral? Yeah. Yeah. What is that? Natural log of
1 by 2
x. Natural log of x plus under root get here. Is it the same answer?
Yes.
Multiple approaches and result is the same. But you cannot avoid IOP. Whether you take CQ root or whether you take the root of this, integration by parts has to be used at some stage of the problem solving. Can you similarly try in this approach solving the second and the third one? Then give me the result. I'll give you 7 minutes.
7 minutes.
You can. But try this method. Is it clear? Fine. Yes, Shweta? The manipulation here would be according to this expression. Okay, anybody wants me to do the second one, raise your hand. Vishali, second one. Sharanya, third one, are you done or do you need my help?
Yes.
Now I'll tell you how to remember this formula. Okay. In all the formulas, you would see that x by 2 is multiplied with the integrand. Yes or no?
Yes.
Do you see that the first term is always x by 2 multiplied with the integrand?
Yes.
Next term is, if you see a plus a square, the next term is plus a square by 2. If you see a minus a, then it will be minus a square by 2. And then again plus a square means plus a square by 2. Do you see that? The next term is the integration of the same integrand. Yes. Have it been in the denominator? Yes. So 1 by root x square plus x square, equal it. What is it?
Log of
x. Natural log of
x plus a square.
Okay. When this was in the denominator, what was the result? Same thing with minus a. When this was in the denominator, what was the result? So this helps you to remember this form. I'll give you some simple ones. Evaluate. First step, you have to
complete
this. Okay. For the first one,
thank you.
if you complete this square, are you getting this? Okay. Which is so instead of integrating this, let's integrate this. So integral of a square minus x square. What is the answer? X by 2. Who is x?
X minus 7 by 2
is your x. So x by 2 under root, I mean same term.
Same term.
You may want to write this also, but this is the simplification of this one. This is the complication of this actually. Okay. Now, plus a square by 2. A square is already 9 by 4. So a square by 2 will be 9 by 8. Sine inverse x by a. Can I say x by a is 2x minus 7 by 3? You may want to take a 1/4 common here as well. So 1/4. Inside the under root, multiply and divide with 1 plus x. It will become x plus 1 by x by under root. Split it up as two terms. Clear, Vishak? Is this term easy to integrate?
Yeah.
No problem with that?
Yeah.
What about this term? Can I do one thing here? Can I put a minus here and a minus x square here and 1 minus 1? See how manipulative I can be. Which is nothing but yes sir. So basically this term I divided it by this, I got this minus minus plus 1 by. Now each of these integrals I know how to evaluate. How do I do the first one? Nischal? Take y minus x square as t square. So minus x dx becomes t dt. So it becomes minus t dt by t. This answer is what? X by 2 under root of 1 minus x square plus a square by 2 sine inverse x by a. This answer is what? Sine inverse x. Let me complete it. So your final answer will be minus t. This is minus t. Can I say if I open the brackets become half sine inverse x? So third one, when you see x minus under root x square minus a square, you will feel the heat of the axis. So let's rationalize the denominator by multiplying and dividing with x plus under root x square minus 1. So in the denominator, yes, we get 1. So basically, this is what you end up getting, right? Now this is simple, x cube by 3. In this, you can take x square minus 1 as t, correct? We take t square as well, no issues. So x dx will become t dt. So x dx will become t dt into t. So it will become t square dt, correct? Correct? Which will give you t cube plus 3, t cube by 3. And t cube is what? T cube is x square minus 1 to the power of 3 by 2. So this is the answer for the third one.